Everyone, welcome to the pre-scene analysis of management case study for November 2018. And this time, they are giving you a case study on Grapple, which is a manufacturing industry. But before we start the case, again, kindly I need to remind you, please have a piece of paper and a pen, and please write down whatever the things I write in the pre-scene analysis. And also, if I have missed any points, please mention it in the comment box. And if you have anything, please comment it. Now let's start with the analysis. As I told you, this is a manufacturing industry where they are manufacturing soft drinks. Grapple, where they are manufacturing soft drinks and also fruit juice. And this is a manufacturing sector. Please keep that in mind. Before we go through the case study, we'll just analyze the table of contents. Introduction, again, it will give you your job description. Now, this comes under the topic of E1, and now it is going to be E2 also. Now, students, examiner will be asking E2 knowledge, but it's better to have a little bit of knowledge of E1, a little bit, not 100%, at least 10% of knowledge, a basic standard knowledge. And Grapple history is once again the business skill, which is also E1 and E2, but mostly it will be E2. Industry background, again, this is again a business skill knowledge. We are giving the industry. Again, it's E2. Analysis of competitors' performance. Again, it's E2, business skills. And also, a little bit of P2, you can think about it. And also, the business skills. Grapple's vision, mission, statement, and strategy. Again, it's again a business skill of E2. Production process. This is again E2, but this is an industry-oriented production process. Then you have distribution of sales outlet. Again, it's mostly on E2 and also a little bit of P2. Then information about staff, which is E2. And also you can say P2 also coming here. Management team and staff, again E2, business skill. Draft from the financial statements, this will be F2. Press coverage, again E2, business skills. Social media coverage, again E2, business skill. And extract from ZLens, data production regulation, which is also part of E2. Students, just keep this in mind. It should be like this, your case analysis. You should know each and everything, and you should analyze each and every information that they have mentioned. Okay? Now, students, let's come to the next page. Introduction. Okay? You are the finance manager. You are the finance manager with Grapple Drinks. Okay. Job description here is finance manager. Now, when you did the OCS, your position was finance officer. Now, you have promoted into finance manager. And I'll write here DM. DM means decision making. Come here. So, this time, you need to be a little more curious of your people skill and also your leadership skill. If you had passed OCS, it can be due to the theory knowledge. But if you look at the MCS, it's not so easy as the OCS. Your primary responsibilities are associated with management accounting. Very good. They are clearly stating its P2 knowledge is very crucial. This means that you often have to liaise with the colleagues against the people skill, negotiation skill, which comes under E2, management of relationship in working environment. I'll write here management of relationship in working environment. Students, if you have not revised this, please revise the topics whatever I mentioned. Management of relationship in working environment. This is one of a core topic in E2. Please keep that in mind, students. including sales, HR, research and development, and operations. David concentrates on financial reporting. Okay, financial reporting. That is the finance director. Again, I'll write here David Guy. The name of the person, David Guy. He is the finance director you will be reporting to. So you should remember the name of these people because you are working in this organization. So some students just mention a finance director. The examiner may pass you, but you cannot score very well in the examination. Because if you are working in your organization, you should mention the name of the people rather than their post. Okay, David concentrates on financial reporting and special projects, and he delegates some responsibility to you. Now, they are telling financial reporting David concentrates, FR. So, you should be specific of the International Accounting Standards and IFRS. And I usually say the topic which is heavily tested in the exam is IFRS 10, the consolidation theory with application. And also, he is clearly mentioning on project management. And I told you, even when I did the OCS analysis, that the CIMA examiner usually tests two types of unseen. Okay, the two types of unseens are, one can be a proposal. Okay, proposal. And the other can be an issue. Again, I told you, proposal is like a new product development. Merger and acquisition are like proposal. But if you look at issues can be like bottleneck. P2 you would have studied. Bottleneck, shortages of raw materials, labor or anything. Bottleneck. And also another thing I can clearly mention is after bottleneck, you can say is something called like a HR issue, it can be there. Team management problem. These are the major things you need to keep in mind. Okay, students, please write this down. And also, please pause it if you need more speed. And you can take your own time and come. Now, students, I'll come to the next section, Grapple History. Students, once again, I'm telling you, please don't spend too much of time on Grapple History. Too much analysis. Again, I'm telling you, you should clearly remember E2, P2 and F2 knowledge because you should apply that. But some knowledges are important, but not too much. Grapple was founded in 1965 by Dudley Grapple in Zetland. Okay, the country is Zetland and the currency they are using is Z dollar. So, you should remember that there is a standard called IAS 21, foreign currency translation when they are moving into another country. Okay. And it was founded in 1965. So they are established because it's very old. They are very established. Okay. Because the company has been running almost for 50 years, I think. Dudley was working as a sales manager for Regency Drink Company. At the time and when it is relocated from Zetland, he decided to take his redundancy. Okay. So Dudley, the founder, as usual in many cases, have knowledge of the industry. So I am very clear, there will be a problem in HR on succession plan. Knowledge on industry he has. Okay, I'll just write in my paper, succession plan. Anyway, most of the cases comes in this order. Succession plan, where there needs to be a person to take over the organization. Dudley incorporated Grapple and invested his redundancy money. Having taken a further bank loan, he acquired premises and started producing and distributing carbonated soft drinks. Example, soda. Soda is a carbonated soft drink. Okay. The business has grown organically since incorporation. Dudley's only child, Roger Grapple, started working for the business on production line in 1985. He was quickly promoted into management position and worked closely with Dudley to grow the business over the year. Okay, so Dudley has found a successor, his son, Roger. But still, it's a family business. I need to mention it's a family business. family business. Still, it is going in the family business orientation. Okay. Now, in the last 20 years, Grapple has introduced a new range products sold in recyclable glasses. So it's something a competitive advantage because people will like it. Carbonated mixtures, still mixtures, and fruit juices. So there is some diversification. In other words, Roger is doing some great job. Diversification. Introduced Grapple and monitored how the market reacted to each one. So they are doing fairly well. Revenues has increased as the business continued to gain market share. Okay. And reputation of quality and value for money. Now, if I think a strat or a SWOT analysis, if I just think at a SWOT analysis, I can generally say their reputation and the value what they have created is a strength. It's a very much strength. It's a strength for the organization compared to its competitors. So they are doing better. Cost have been kept under control. Purchasing team review the price of raw materials every quarter to make sure Grapple is getting good value from its suppliers. The production process is closely monitored and wastage is kept to a minimum, although still it occurs. Despite the growth, the business has continued to be operated from a single site. Okay. A weakness, I can say, is they are operating only at a single site because they are not flexible. Suppose if there is an accident, like a fire in that single site, what will happen is they will not have another site. And another question you should ask is whether the place is insured, because it's very important. And they are telling the wastage is controlled, and that's a question mark. How? Dudley's legacy is that Grapple has always had a good reputation for how it looks after its employees. So the HR is very strong. In other words, they have taken over their staffs very well. Remuneration packages are above average of industry. And staff welfare is important to Grapple. Health and safety legislation is adhered rigorously. So see, these are the points, health and safety. Those are strength, but it can be turning out as a threat also. Because what can happen in the unseen me, they may say that in the factory there can be some bad incidents where some employees are injured. So please be careful. The factory is located in the edge of a small town. Again, keep that in mind, sensitive information. It's very sensitive. Small town, very sensitive. Okay. Close to an area renowned its natural beauty. So there can be pollutions in the future in your unseen. Please be careful. Grapple work closely with the local community to make sure production process and its factory do not harm the natural environment in any way. But again, there should be some environmental audit to be conducted. Whether this is transparent or not, this should be told to the people. Dudley died 10 years ago, age 72, and Roger is the new chief executive. Anyway, in family business, this is the process. Having worked in the business throughout his adult life, in his will, Dudley bequeathed 100% equity shareholding to his four grandchildren and Roger. That means the grandchildren has 40% and Roger has a controlling stake of 60%. Roger's children has pursued their own career and not interested becoming part in management team for Grapple. Now see, that's a big weakness because the family members are not interested in the business. So what happens is that 40% can be sold in a private placement. That means you find some private investors, or the next thing is where you can go for an IPO and issue those shares to get money in the future. Or one thing is IFRS 2. You would have studied a standard called IFRS 2, share based payment. If the children are not invested, what can Roger do? He can have some contract with quality staff and he can say, okay, I will give you this much of shares at an exercise price. You work for me. So these are the points that you need to take this over. Please write over whatever the topics I am saying. They have kept their shareholding but have indicated that they would be prepared to sell them to raise funds for their future. Roger is age 55 and would retire in the next 5 years. Therefore, I told you, succession plan, but it is not for David, it's for Roger. It's for Roger, the second CEO of the organization. Grapple is an unlisted company. I told you, there can be chances of an IPO or they can be acquired by another company, and prepares its financial statement in accordance with IFRS. So standard knowledge is very crucial. Financial statements are prepared in Z dollars and there are 100 cents for Z dollars. Students, 100 cents for Z dollars means it's like UK currency, where £1 equals 100 cents. Okay, but if you look at country like Kuwait, okay, their currency is completely different. Example, one dinar will be 1,000 cents. One dinar will be 1,000 cents. That's the reason they are giving that information. So please be careful. It's just a normal information, nothing to panic about. Now, students, let's come to the next paper. Industry background. Ready? I think we can start going through this. The soft drink sector is a mature section in the beverage market. It has been made out of carbonated, that is fizzy with gas, and non-carbonated still beverages. Like fizzy, you can say like Coke is fizzy, okay? Non-carbonated normal drinks, like for example, like soft drinks like cream soda, those things. The industry was established in Zetland over 100 years ago, and today there are two main manufacturers as well as smaller one. Two main manufacturers. Let's see who they are. In Zetland, the soft drinks market is dominated by two main producers, Party Pop and Carnival. Like in the world, Pepsi and what is the other one? I think you obviously know it's Coke. Pepsi and Coke. Okay, Pepsi and Coke, similar to Pepsi and Coke. Both these entities have globally strong brands, same thing, but are registered in Zetland and listed in the stock market also. Other firms in Zetland are unlisted and they do not enjoy the same level of brand awareness. In order to compete with number of smaller firms, have consolidated through acquisition. Although Tigerfish and Grapple remains the ownership management of their founders and family. So they are clearly indicating that there can be a situation where a major company can buy this small company, or Tigerfish, there's a chance that these two companies can join together. Two companies can join together. Merger or acquisition can be there. So please keep that in mind. I'll come to the next page. So it will be easy for you all. Okay, now the recent analyst report shows the market in Zetland being divided as follows. Okay. That is, they are clearly stating that Party Pops 45% of market share and 45.25, that is little drop, and even Carnival also you find a little bit drop. In other words, these two are the major players, but they will identify their market share is dropping. And Grapple is, I think, the company which is growing. The growth rate is there with Grapple. Tigerfish is also going down and other producers are stagnant. So students, keep these things in mind. Stagnant. Market size remains significant. Okay. The importance of having a strong brand control, brand cannot be overstated in soft drinks market. One of the main reasons why Party Pops and Carnival have been hugely successful is the fact they have brand legacies founded on significant advertising campaign and promote the emotional and lifestyle attachment to their product range. In other words, the same thing which is followed by Coke. Because Coke is usually based on emotions of countries, lifestyle of countries, sports, everything, they attract. They use big data for aspects of business from marketing and manufacturing. Now, it's a topic of P2, big data, and also it's there in E2. But I just want to clarify. Now, if you look at big data, it's like Facebook. What they are doing is currently when you are using Facebook, it will show you some advertisement which you are interested in. So this is how these companies get the target audience. So please keep that in mind. And it's unethical because privacy of the consumers are being bought. So keep that in mind. Party Pops and Carnival needs to sell high volumes as they are cost leaders. Their margins are some of the lowest in the industry. This is largely due to additional spending on advertising and packaging innovation. Tiger Fish and Grapple and other producers are more concerned with quality and product differentiation. They do not distribute globally and so manage to keep costs down, enabling them to raise their margin. Smaller producers have identified the need to move away from non-recyclable packaging and follow larger entities' lead. The industry is striving to find ways of making manufacturing process more efficient and effective and save cost and margin. Now see, again, there are some proposals like JIT or TQM, Total Quality Management. So these are some things that they can ask you in the examination. So please keep that in mind. And these people are cost leaders. So they are very difficult to be flexible, but the small companies can easily be flexible. What are the challenges facing in industry? So put a star for this. In the recent year, there had been growing pressure from health lobbies in Zetland who believes that sugar content of soft drinks is too high. Again, so it's again a little bit of ethics and CSR. There can be some issues coming in the unseen. Schools and colleges are educating children to try healthier sugar-free alternatives with comparable taste and quality. I think they may be asking you to go for dairy products or some other natural types. This has not made a huge impact on the market, but it has prompted most manufacturers to produce new ranges of sugar-free energy drinks. They have a variety of sophisticated flavors, colorful packaging that appeals that under 25. Party Pops and Carnival has experimented with innovative styles and packaging and special edition that follows the trend. Example, I think you would have seen Coca-Cola Light. They say Coca-Cola Light where the sugar content is less. It's one of a branding technique. Just keep that in mind also. And interest in celebrities. I told you, brand marketing is very crucial. Using celebrities on screen in the media. A bottle tops that maintains the fizziness of drinks are being developed. Party Pops and Carnivals are investing large sums in research and development of this. Iconic style are increasing awareness and status of their brand. This has helped them to maintain their dominance in the market. True. What are the key drivers of success within the industry? It is believed that there are two main drivers of success. Demonstration by manufacturers of their green credentials. So, government will sometimes provide tax subsidies for green credentials. Okay, please keep that in mind. Tax subsidies and people may also like. Sustainable packaging is seen as a way forward. So, ultimately, Grapple is producing recyclable bottles. So, Grapple is in the right track. But if you look at the major two companies, they are not performing very well as Grapple. So keep that in mind, students. Preservation of quality of the product. Again, it's very crucial. What are the opportunities for the industry? Brand extension and product development. Keep that in mind. Brand extension. So it's a proposal that can be an unseen proposal. I told you, new market, they can go to a new market or they can develop a new product. So they can give you an investment appraisal, P2 topic. Where you need to identify whether the project is feasible or not. They may already do the calculation and give it, but you need to be very careful when doing the applications. In the coming year, the industry needs to concentrate on offering a more varied product range that still offers quality to the market demand. The variety should come from a broader range of flavor and improved recipes and textures. This in turn will create volume growth and present differentiators in the industry. True. Packaging. The industry should continue to find innovative and sustainable packaging options to attract wider range of customers. The manufacturers should work with new packaging designers and marked in order to gain market share. I can mention, I will write it here, it's very important. I think you should revise this, something called a balanced scorecard. Balanced scorecard. Balanced scorecard. It has been tested in the exam many times. Please keep that in mind. Now, if you look at balanced scorecard, it has like four perspectives. I'll just tell it in a summary. One is known as the internal perspective. One is known as the internal perspective. And the other one is learning and growth perspective. That is the innovation. Learning and growth perspective. And then students, we have the next thing after learning and growth is something called customer perspective. Customer perspective. And the final thing is the financial perspective. So I'm not doing this in detail, but I'm just giving you a summary of this because this has been tested in the exam. So please be careful because it's on the gain on the sustainability. Consolidation of competition. The larger entities will continue to dominate the market, obviously. The industry has high barriers to entry. So you see port of five forces. Whenever you see high barrier to entry, it comes port of five forces. Clear? Okay, just keep those things in mind. What are five forces? So smaller producers need to consolidate further if they want to gain the market share. Okay, that's the thing I told you. Tiger Fizz is again a small company. And the other one is Grapple, which is also another small company. So there can be situation where these two are merging. So they may be asking you some theories such as IFRS 12 joint arrangement, IFRS 11 joint arrangement, and IFRS 10, which is consolidated financial statement, consolidated financial statement. So please keep those things in mind, consolidated financial statement, and also IAS 28, which is investment in associates. So these areas may be tested in the examination. So please keep that in mind. Analysis of the competitor's performance. Okay. Source businessfact.zl. Okay. Disclaimer, the financial information provided on this website is taken from financial information that has been filed at Zetland's government company registration and filing office. Business Facts will not be responsible for investment decision based on the information. So this is just to understand the industry, but you cannot make any investment decision, acquisition or merger. Party Pops, Carnival, Grapple, Tiger Fleas and Blue Jay, another small player. Now look at the financial statement. It's very difficult to compare because different people are having different financial year end. Yes or no? Different people are having different financial year end. It's very difficult to compare different financial year end. I'll mention here different financial year end. You can't compare. Very hard. Year end. And then the currencies are same. So that's good. Revenue. If you look at this, it's growing by 2%. And Carnival 1%, but if you look at Grapple, the growth is 61%. So Grapple is, I can say, it's a star in the market. It's a star in the market. It's a star in the market. And I think these two have come to their cash cow stage. Cash cow stage. They have grown so much. And Tiger Fizz going negative, something wrong. So there can be chances that Grapple can buy Tiger Fizz. Keep that in mind. Okay. And Blue Jay is also having a 0.0% growth. Profit before tax. Also good for all the companies. Total assets. If you look at the size wise, Party Pops is huge. Carnival is medium. And Grapple, Tiger Fizz and Blue Jay are just the smaller categories. Liabilities wise, I think if you look at Carnival and Party Pops, both are having the liabilities, but Grapple is having less. And if you look at Tiger Fizz, it's a little bit geared. You can feel that. And Blue Jay also. Employee numbers 924, 836, 97, 89, and 26. So here when they are merging, there is a problem because equal number of employees are there, and these people have huge number of people, and this only has 26. And I think this is a very small emerging company. You should keep that in mind, emerging company. So this is the analysis of competitors' performance. That means Grapple is doing very well, but Roger has a problem on succession plan. That you should keep in mind. Okay, now let's coming to the next one. Grapple's vision, mission and strategy. The following has been taken from Grapple's website. Grapple is currently one of the major supplier of soft drinks to restaurant retail trade within Zetland. Okay, they have restaurant and retail trade. Okay, that's good. But also we should consider, do they have any supermarket tie-ups? Supermarket tie-ups, which is very crucial. Okay. To be the world's leading manufacturer and supplier of soft drink, that is our vision of the company. And it's by Dudley Grapple, the founder. But the children, I think, may not have these type of value. So even if there's a management change, there will be a problem in changing the mission and vision of the organization. If you look at the mission, to combine the use of sustainable, high quality ingredients and expert manufacturing techniques to produce unique soft drink experience. Okay, unique soft drink. That's by Roger. Our strategy. To grow Grapple's business while maintaining quality. So in the future proposals, you should always see the first concern is quality. Conflicting objectives may come where you can outsource. I'll write here, outsource. You can outsource also. Chances are there. You can outsource some of your functions. Some of your functions. So you should always concentrate on what? Quality. You should always concentrate on something called quality. And also, they are telling there is a shift in the market towards premium products, and directors believe Grapple is well placed to strengthen their position by expanding distribution to new markets and developing new products. I think you can mention something called Ansoff Matrix. There is a topic called Ansoff Matrix. So that can be coming just application wise, not to memorize in detail. Just basic application. Our successful brands are known for the superior taste and has been matched by our competitors, not been matched by the competitors. So there is a success here. They are the secret formula. I think this is the Grapple's mission, vision and statement. Students, production process. Before starting this, I need to clearly mention that this production process, just a minute, this production process please keep that in mind. This production process is usually given to understand sensitivity. As a CMA student or any accountant, you should not memorize the production process. Please do not memorize the production process. Please do not overanalyze the production process, but understand the production process like an accountant. Okay. Carbonated soft drinks and mixtures. Carbonated soft drinks and mixtures are those that contains a dissolved carbon dioxide. Flavored syrup is mixed with the water that has been carbonated and chilled. So this is again a manufacturing process. The recipe of carbonated soft drink is simple. So think, students, there is no patent. Anyone can start. It's very easy and allows production of large volumes of bottles to be produced on a daily basis. Keep that in mind. Now these are the process. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think 4 are there. Water comprises of 90%. Grapple's carbonated soft drink. This is sourced from local spring held in large tanks. So you should always see whether the supplier is providing an ethical water, or he is giving that what is belonging to the people also. Chances are there. The water is boiled to remove any impurities and may include organic matters and bacteria, and then tested to make sure the desired pH level is assumed. Now here sensitivity comes in, because the cleanliness is there. So we need to check in the unseen whether there will be a process here, because the water purifying is very crucial. There may be still particles at stage, so the water is then filtered through a layer of sand and glass bead. Next, the water is sterilized with chlorine at final check to make sure any remaining organic matter is removed. An activated carbon filter removes the traces of chlorine from the water. Quality control staff carry out the test to make sure there is no impurity. So there is will be a question mark in the quality control staff. Who are they and who is responsible? The accountability is very crucial. So the sensitivity involved. Adding flavor. The fruit flavor concentrates or fruit juice pulp residues depending on the product. And sugars are added to the water tank in room and pressurized with carbon dioxide. Now see, sugar are added. Now you should be very careful. Sugar is also not healthy for many people. So we should see the proportions. We say something called mix variance. It's a P1 topic, but they have tested that in P2 also. Please keep that in mind. Grapple's ingredients include syrup that is known to contain some bacteria. Please keep that in mind. Bacteria are there. The water tanks are sterilized further with ultraviolet radiation and flash pasteurizing, rapid heating and cooling of water. The mix should now be sterilized fully. Further quality control tests are carried out to make sure the traces of bacteria are not present. So here there is a risk here, because if there is some negligence, the bacteria will be there in the drink what they are producing, and this may cause something called tooth decay for the consumers. So please keep that in mind. Carbonization involves dissolving carbon dioxide in a flavored mixture of water. The solubility of gas decreases as the temperature of water increases, so it's important to keep the water at constant cold temperature. Again, these are industry knowledge. Bottling and labeling. This process is carried out immediately after carbonization, and the bottles are sealed to preserve the carbon pressure in the drink. The cold bottles attract condensation of moisture, so labels and final packaging is applied once the bottles have reached the room temperature. Quality control tasks take swabs from inside the bottle to check they are not contaminated before the drink is added. So again, mostly there is huge sensitivity involved in this process. But students, they may give you a situation, but you need to handle it in a leadership-oriented and people-oriented manner, like which has come in the previous cases also. Still soft drinks and mixtures. Still soft drinks and mixtures are made using the same process as above without carbonization step. Same thing. But again, sensitivity there of the bacteria that are there. But one thing, students, they can have something called ISO quality certification, because that is missing. Because if they have a quality certification from one of the major regulation body, they can be transparent to the consumers also. So that is one weakness they have here. Now let's see, the next one is fruit juices. The popular flavors of Grapple are apple and pears. Fruit is brought directly from growers in Zetland. Okay, they are buying directly from the growers. In other words, the farmers who are doing it. So a little bit of ethics needs to be concerned, whether they are paying them higher or the reasonable amount, or are they exploiting them. Raw material purchase. Harvested fruits is delivered to Grapple and verified for quality. It must be healthy and ripe. The fruit is washed as per low pressure water cannon and then tipped into a hopper. The hopper contains mechanism that removes leaves, branches, stalks, sands and stones. So again, these are the technical, industry technical knowledge the people should know. pulp preparation. Conveyor belts transfer the fruits into storage room, where it is placed in a feeder made acid-proof material and plastics, and do not contaminate the fruit. Quality control staff checks for contamination. Highly trained employees inspect fruits and reject any that does not satisfy requirement. Waste is sold to farmers as animal feed and used for fertilizers. High quality fruit is then sent to the mill, which cuts, sieves and presses the fruit. But again, wastage is a factor there once again. There can be some wastage also if they are not having proper purchasing department. Pressing and yielding. Pulp fruits passes through pipes heated with hot water to process stage. Here it is pumped into pressing space. We are using high power pistons which press the juice through filtering element to juice chamber. Pasteurizing removes the enzymes. Quality control staffs make sure that there is the case. Packaging and bottling. Pasteurized juice is piped through the packaging, bottling and labeling area, which is fully automated. Just keep that in mind. Quality control. Grapple's quality control staff work as a production team and take regular samples from batches at different stages of production. The first batch after any change, example setup, cleaning, mineral is always tested by batch wise. Now here comes the next area, distribution and sales outlet. Now if you look at large Coke like company, they are made successes due to their network they have throughout the world. Now let's see what's happening here also. In 2018, Roger Grapple commissioned a local analytical data company, Sales Stats Zedlen, to produce data identifying distribution of Grapple's product in Zedlen using internal sales record. The report contained the following information. North, South and Central region. But what about the Western region? I think the Western region can be a market development in your unseen. So I am writing here the Western region. The West is nothing. They have not exploited the Western region. Supermarkets 64%, 52% and 62%. Good. Other retail, restaurants and bar and airline, it's a very good segment. They have gone into this. Okay, and one more thing, they can also go into events, like major events, sports, sponsoring, everything. They are missing that. Still soft drinks, again, they are doing the same thing. Again, supermarkets are doing very well. And there are some other opportunities on airline, restaurant and other retail. And one more thing, I just wanted to be clarifying. Airlines, when the passengers are traveling in the flight, what can happen is the taste can be little changing. So the company needs to be very specific when they are producing for these type of products, so they can be flexible when they are doing it. And also they should have something called return analysis and customer complaints. I think they have not mentioned anything, but in the unseen, customer complaints may arise. So please keep that in mind. I'll write here. Product and cost of sales prices. Here they are giving the costing information, P2. Students, again, please be very careful. There is something called a topic called throughput accounting. Please be careful. Just revise these topics, throughput accounting. That is selling price minus direct material. When there is bottleneck, we do this. I'm not doing this in detail, but I'm just telling you have an idea about this. Sorry. Okay. Now, students, if you look at the products ranges they have given the products that are being sold, and these are the selling prices of the products. Now, see, 2019 prices are going up. So, one thing can be inflation impact also. Okay, or another thing is customer loyalty. Again, prices are going up. Mixtures also, prices are going up. And everything, prices are going up in 2019. And they are producing only 250 ml bottles. But there may be chance where they produce 500 ml bottles, cans they can produce in cans, like Coca-Cola producers in cans, and also 1 liter large mega bottle also they can produce. Keep those things in mind. These can be informations what can be tested in the exam. Grapple standard production cost per 250 milliliters. They are given the cost. Water, syrup, fruit pulp, direct labor, please keep that in mind. Production overhead, packaging and labeling. And here the prices are there, 144, 127 and 225, because I told you fruits are a little expensive because of that. And sales budget also, if you look at sales budget, they are budgeting to go up. Volumes are increasing, okay, and also carbonated water also volumes are increasing. I think they have more opportunities if they expand to the western region of the country, or they can become an international company where they can go to another country also. This is very crucial, please keep that in mind. There can be an issue here, staff. I'll start with this important notice. Hygiene is our top priority. I told you bacteria, everything is there in the production process. So please keep that in mind. Carelessness will not be tolerated. Again, I'm telling you, they are clearly telling carelessness will not be tolerated. Smoking and the use of mobile telephones are strictly prohibited. So supervision is a question mark. Whether who is there to supervise this supervision is very super. Whether do they have CCTV cameras in the organization? Please keep that in mind. Now let's see here, all staff entering the manufacturing and bottling sites for all products will wear a clean white overall. Safety goggle, earplugs, hairnets, non-slip shoes provided by Grapple. So we should think who is the supplier of giving this. So there can be cost cutting done by the supplier or the purchasing, because it's clear sense that their cost are under control. So they would have given some low quality goggles, everything. Wash hands with hygiene fluid dispensers on entry to the shop. Negligence can be happening. Without washing also they can come. Leave food and drinks in the breakout areas. Again, sometimes they can have chewing gums while doing the work. This is practical if there is no proper supervision. A daily cleaning of equipments. Again, it's very crucial. Ensure that all remains of products are removed from production equipments. So they should clean it. Pre-rinse all items with hot water from filtration system using high pressure hoses to remove any superficial staining. Wash hoppers, feeders, mixing bowls and other containers with cleaning agents and storage area. Do not use cleaning products other than those provided by Grapple's maintenance team. They prepare solution on concentration recommended by health and safety executive of Zetlin. Unauthorized access to storage room is forbidden. So these are very sensitive information. And they are also clearly stating, rinse equipment thoroughly with hot clean water. Flow to be disinfected at the end of each day. Further information can be found in staff intranet. If you have any queries, please speak to your line manager. Okay, there is an issue, line manager. So communication issue is there. So their induction is very crucial. Sometimes the manager may all just read this and go. So due to the negligence, staff would have not read this, because they need to have a proper role play and how to work they should show. That's very crucial. Management team and staff. Okay. Roger Grapple has worked for Grapple for his adult life with school and good qualification, but not attend university. But he has industry knowledge, nothing to worry about. He started work on production line in his father's factory. For 15 years worked in sales and marketing team. So there is nothing to worry about him. But the problem is his children, because they are not interested. The finance director. David Guy is a qualified accountant and worked for Grapple as the finance director for 10 years. In his previous role, he was the group financial controller for one of Grapple's competitors whose shares are listed in Zetlin Stock Exchange. In that role, he reported directly to the group finance director and was responsible for managing financial accounting team who produced group financial statements. That is consolidation. Please keep that in mind. He joined Grapple to become the finance director. The demand on his finance team has grown in recent years as there has been more emphasis on improved reporting for board. Human resource manager, very crucial person, because staffs needs to be properly aligned because of the safety and the cleanliness of the juice. Yulia Pushkin has worked as a human resource consultant for many years. Consultant, please keep that in mind. Consultant, that means just giving some ideas but not in the implementation role. In manufacturing sector in Zetland, she joined Grapple 3 years ago as a full-time member of the team, as Dudley wanted to make sure the staff welfare was known to be important driver of success. The board would like to appoint a director responsible for human resources, and Yulia has indicated that she would not like the promotion. She is feeling overworked at present. Now see, HR director feels overworked means what about the staff? I think they may also have an issue. At present, relying on finance function for support with some of the staff management issue. That is an issue here. And the sales and marketing director, the next person, Li Ying, has worked in carbonated drink industry for many years. She graduated with top honors in marketing from leading university in Zetland. Her final year dissertation on big data analytics has been published in several languages for leading marketing journal. She has had 3 regional managers, each one located in responsible north, south and central region. Each regional manager has a small team of sales representatives. Managers do not meet customers directly but are responsible for budgetary control and staff management issue. The reps are responsible for creating database of local customers within their region and increasing Grapple's market share. So public relationship is an issue, because how they will understand what people think about the market? There should be someone who is very closer to the general public because of the diversity. Now, the next person is the production director, Matthew John. If you look at Matthew Jones, he is responsible for production process and oversees the research and development function. He started work as an apprentice for an engineering business, although he has worked for Grapple for 25 years. He provides himself in knowing production process thoroughly and responsible for making sure machinery is maintained. The production and the research and development manager report to Matthews directly. Carbonated mixer production manager, Royce Eng, joined Grapple straight from university 8 years ago. 8 years ago she has joined, but straight from university, but 8 years she has worked, so no risk, I think so, since 8 years is good experience. Still mixer production manager Abdul Singh joined Grapple from Party Pops 3 years ago, where he was employed in a similar role. So the HR would have attracted also Mr. Abdul Singh to join. And fruit juice production manager Wilson Cooper joined Grapple as an apprentice 10 years ago and has recently been promoted to the role following the retirement of his predecessor. So see, the HR is very good here, because people, labor turnover is very less, the people are liking it. So it's going smooth at the moment. It's a smooth HR at the moment. Research and development manager Anisha Mistry has worked in research and development for her entire career and moved into carbonated drink industry 1 year ago. Okay. That's again an issue, but later we can identify. Staffing levels, including directors and senior managers. Now, if you look at production, there are 78 full-time people. Finance only 4. HR 1 person. That's what she's telling. She's finding it overpressured. Marketing and sales 10 are there. And senior management admin 4 are there. And 3 quality control staff. It's not enough, I say. Not enough 3 quality control staff, because the sensitivity is very high and there should be some audits done for them. Internal audits are very crucial, because sensitivity is very crucial. Students, financial statements. I have already done the calculations and it's available in my Facebook page, where you can check all the numbers there. But I will just give you an indication on how the company is going, but I will not be doing the calculation of this, because it's already there. If you have any problems, you can ask me. I will definitely reply you when you are having in the comment section. Revenue, I told you the company's growth is super. It's growing very well. cost of sales also grown, gross profit is also growing, distribution cost growing, admin is also growing, operating profit growing, finance cost also grown, profit income tax. So do you see at the end, performance wise, the company is doing very well. It's not bad also, it's growing. The performance wise is growing. So expansion is taking place also with the cost movement. So there's a good movement here, we can identify that. If you look at the statement of financial position, property, plant and equipment, there's a drop here. I think there may be some impairment loss or something. We need to be very careful. Intangible asset also, there's a drop. Keep careful. Inventories have gone up. Receivables have gone up. I think airlines will pay later. The airlines company will not pay on cash. Even supermarkets will not pay on time. Retail people will have a minimum cash, but airlines and supermarket will take more time to pay money. Cash balances 2.1, which has increased by 0.5. Share capital, $1 share each, they are given. Retained earnings is also fine. Loans has also increased. There's a question mark. Why did they increase the loan? And deferred tax, IAS 12, you need to have a little bit idea about that, because they are giving on green credential. Trade payables have increased. I think that is the fruit growers, where they buy fruit, and the water suppliers, everyone. Tax payable also has increased. Just have an idea of this. Students, if you look at the statement of cash flow, okay, profit before tax, finance cost is as it is, depreciation, amortization is there, inventory increase, receivable increase, payable increase. So you should check that they are expanding, but the expansion should not have a working capital issue. But I don't see like that, because they are doing pretty well. Interest paid, taxation paid, and payments to purchase non-current asset, 7 purchase, but the non-current asset value has gone down. That's a question mark there. And proceeds from loan, dividend paid 5.2, which is significant. I think the grandchildren are demanding dividends. So sometimes the grandchildren may also want to sell their shares and they may move on to another organization. And this year there's a 0.5 increase. So 2.5 cash balance. Students, the press coverage of Zedlen Weekly, I'll just be summarized here. Digby Denton left school at age of 15 with no qualification, similar like Mr. Dudley. But Dudley has a sales manager. And now looking back on long career of soft drink industry, where he made his fortune at 76, having recovered from serious heart attack last year, he is nearing to end of his lifelong involvement with Tiger Fizz and finding it hard to let it go. Tiger Fizz is my baby, he says. He started it with the inheritance of trading unit from his grandmother in 1972. He quickly realized that there was a demand of carbonated soft drinks in Zedlen. He knew that he had competitors selling similar products, but he managed to survive by keeping his sales prices low and cutting cost on packaging. He admits that he has an old-fashioned approach to manufacturing and losing touch with some of modern process. However, he prides himself on being a reliable employer or a loyal workforce. Many of Digby's management team is nearing retirement, having worked for most of their working life. This disappoints him, and he was hoping to leave the business is capable in hand. Local analyst has not been kind to Tiger Fizz. Reports have indicated Digby became ill and business started to lose the way it was strong from top. Its branding is strong and demand for two of its products, Fizzy Fizz and Still Fizz, have kept pace with other industry, but Fruit Fizz is falling out of fashion. Digby remains optimistic, however believes that his Tiger Fizz can be changed. So, you see, there is an opportunity here where our company, Grapple, can buy this organization. So there is some opportunity. Grapple can buy this organization, share for share exchange, or the two major things, Carnival or the Pop one, can buy this company. So please keep that in mind. This is an indication what may happen in the future. And again, the Zedlen Herald, I think you can go through this. I will be telling it in a summary what this tells it. Again, he is clearly emphasizing about the sugar content which is there in the soft drinks, and this is a TV show, soft drinks, and he is telling that many people should not drink these type of drink. But one weird thing that happened in his TV show, that no one from the drink manufacturing industry were present. So it can be a business as usual also. Like, for example, people say smoking causes cancer, but still, how many TV shows would have come regarding smoking, and how many road shows would have been there? But still, it's the people who ultimately decide. So sometimes in this economy, that this show can be a failure. So it's your leadership skill, how you are going to tackle the answer in the examination. Please keep that in mind also, students. Now students, let's come to the next one. Drinks Manufacturing Monthly. Again, they are telling you some new production process, what that has been taken place. I'll just keep that in mind. You can just go through this. They were telling the automated production technology and how it is efficient. So again, there can be proposal in this. Please go through this automated technology also. Don't go through in detail, just a brief idea. Drink Manufacturing Monthly, the horseshoe manufacturing layout. Again, this is also one of the process they are telling how it can be done. Just go through this also. It's all our proposals. It's all our proposals that is given. And the social media coverage, where the sports minister has told they are going to have an athletic event in the country. So they are seeking for sponsors. And I think there will be some unseen situation on green credential. So please be careful about this green accounting, everything, green credential, social responsibility, everything. And they are giving the data protection, that is, they are telling at the moment protecting consumer data is an important thing, and it's a crime also to share the data. So if you look at the major company like Party Pop, okay, and Carnival, they are currently using the customers' data. So for them, there will be an issue. But in your unseen, there can be situation on marketing where they may ask you to identify consumer information, everything. So you need to consider these things. Now, students, just to summarize, I need to tell you, just keep that in mind. Just to summarize, students, in exams, pre-seen is important for MCS, but industry knowledge, not memorizing. Please keep that in mind. Industry knowledge, not memorizing. Industry knowledge, not memorizing. I will explain that. But you should give priority to the learning outcomes of each subject, E2, P2 and F2. Please keep that in mind, students. Again, I'll just tell you what is industry knowledge. There was a budget in one company. It's a past paper question. There was a budget in a company that was given in the exam where you should tell the weaknesses. The budget was an incremental budget. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. And it's a monthly budget, like January, February, March, April, May. And the industry was optical industry, which is specs for vision care. Okay, specs, spectacles. What happened? Many students failed this exam by just writing theory, like OCS. They were writing about incremental budget theory, but only 10% of the students found out that this is wrong, because in optical industry, it's very difficult to have constant sales which are growing. Because if it is a sunglass company, there can be growth due to fashion. But if you practically see people who wear specs, they use specs for a period of more than 1 year. Correct? So they gave an idea that most of the people were telling this is right, but some students mentioned this is wrong because it's not commercially feasible, because in optical industry, people will not use specs on a consistent basis. Likewise, if we come to our industry, of Grapple, what we can say, it's a fast moving consumer good. So again, you should worry about the expiry date, whether how many months these people are keeping. So those are the important factors you need to consider. And mostly students, I want you to think in a common sense basis. Common sense basis. And students, once again, I'm telling you, if you have any problems, you can let me know in the comment box below. And thank you very much for joining and watching this video. Take care. God bless everyone. Good luck.